Tell me about diversity, Erica.
So I'm one of the researchers here working at NEP, and one of the things we're interested in is the species composition and the species abundance of a lot of the animals here, specifically for me, the insects. And the alpha diversity is the insects I'm finding in this community, in this tiny bit of environment, about 4,000 acres. That is its alpha diversity. You can see in this little tube here. But we can then move on and we compare it. So I'm not just stuck at NEP, I go to other places around the world. But one of them is my local community in London. And I've been studying the insects there as well. And by comparing across these two different sites, we can work out the beta diversity. So we know a lot of these species are going to be similar, but they're not going to be a totally the same community. And then we can add all of this together. We compare all the alpha, the beta diversity, and this gets together to make the gamma diversity. And the gamma diversity of the UK is going to be very different to where I was collecting in Honduras. So this is some of the insects that we found in Honduras. And although there may be similar families, the species composition of this is likely to be very different to the ones we found in NEP and in London. And so this is the gamma diversity.
And I guess that's really important when we think about conservation. So we want to obviously protect gamma diversity, but then think about the beta diversity, think about the different species on different islands, on different mountains in the Andes, and make sure we protect those.
Yes, because the numbers, we might say they may have the same species richness or species abundance, but the numbers are only one part of the diversity. So knowing what the individual species are helps us to look at the true value, the true worth of these different environments that we're studying.